So I've let this sit overnight, and now I'm ready to trim it and to add the handle. So the first thing I'm gonna do, I've left it on the bat that I threw it on. I haven't even undercut it, actually. And so it's really well attached and it's actually still pretty well centered. So obviously I'm only gonna be trimming this bottom sort of third to get some of the excess clay off and to refine the shape. And this part I'm leaving alone. And obviously, it would be impossible to trim this any other way, really. I can't turn it upside down, obviously, and I can't put it in a chuck because it's such an irregular shape now. So in order to trim it, this is really the only option. So I'm gonna get it going pretty fast. I'm going to start down here, just very lightly. Taking off that excess clay. And what I like to do is leave the original thickness of the clay right down here at the bottom sort of quarter inch, so that just until the last minute, so that I can really see how much clay I've taken off. The other nice thing about trimming right side up with a piece like this is that you can just go in and feel how much excess clay you have left. You feel how thick your walls are. And smooth this out, see what it looks like. take off this excess clay at the bottom, this original that I left there to sort of as a guide. I'm gonna take it off to see what the form looks like without it. All right, that is about where I want it to be. I'm gonna go in with a sponge and just a dry sponge and just clean up some of these throwing marks so that there's not such a differentiation between where I trimmed, sorry, not trimmed, throwing marks, trimming marks, where I trimmed and where I didn't. And then we are gonna pull a handle and attach it.